So what is the Boolean type for? Now, you guys probably have heard that, and you know that, that well, computers are, you know, infused with the idea of zeros and ones, right? We think by ourselves, when the first thing you think when you think about programming is that zeros and ones everybody's talking about. Where does it come in? Now, Boolean is a very good example of the idea of a zero and a one. You know, and in common in pop psych, in pop psychology, people think about zero as if you watch The Matrix, the zeros and ones come up, you know, coding and hacking, and people are like, what are these things? Well, it's a good way of evaluating something, right? So the zero might be the something that's not one in this case. So in the Boolean way, a zero and a one equates to true or false. So that's all the Boolean is. It's that there's two values, that you have a true and false. And it's actually the most archaic way that the computer works, true and false values, quasi Boolean values, right? So in this case, you see a couple code for Booleans. Now, Booleans are extensively used in computer science. When we're using if statements, and we're going to get to that also, we have to use tests, right? So we sometimes want to see, is the object a cat? Is the object a dog? That's the general if statement. But sometimes we want to know, is the door, we have a door, say, right? And we want to know, is the door open or closed, right? That's what we're talking about when we're talking about Booleans. Is the door open or is the door closed? There's two conditions, right? It's open or closed. So if it's closed, the door is not open. And if it's open, the door is not closed, right? So you get the idea of Booleans here, the idea that you have a statement that can either be true or false, right? And it's being done in a variable type. Now, Boolean is a very interesting variable. Last time we talked about ints, a Boolean is not just a one or two or three. These guys only have, well, two values. They have true or they have false. No matter how long the Boolean expression is, it can either go to two things, true or false, right? Now, you can write it out. And what's nice about Boolean, so you can also put an expression in the Boolean that will either evaluate the true or false. So let's quickly test it out. And I want to kind of jack up some code to show you guys what this would look like, right? So if we're going to go to our IDE, to our favorite IDE in this case, IntelliJ IDE, you guys have a different version, right? Now, I'm just going to quickly make this bigger. So in this case with IntelliJ, let me just quickly make this a bit bigger, right? So we want to be looking at Booleans. I've already typed up my Boolean here, but let's quickly see what a Boolean is, how to evaluate this, and how to test Boolean expressions here. Okay, so you can see this Boolean is age is equal to true, system.out.println is age. Okay, so if I go ahead and I hit run, I'm just going to quickly jam up this. I go ahead and I hit run, I see there's a true, right? So the true is what the expression, the Boolean expression evaluates to, right? It's a true statement. And this is what I typed up. So if you look at this, this is what I typed up initially, right? So it's almost like I remember when we had a type, we just evaluated and we run the program and it says exactly what I wrote. But sometimes it's not as obvious. I don't necessarily say it's true or false, but I might have a statement in it. Like I might put something in it, right? And I print out a Boolean value, but I don't necessarily say it's true or false. Let's try that out as well. Let me first go with false, right? If I say it's false, this is the two ways a Boolean could be, and I then go and run it. Let's try and run this expression. Okay, so let's do this quickly. Now I can see it's false. So I've typed false and I've typed true before. Let's do something else. Let's do something interesting. Now we worked with ints last time, right? So if I say, let's say I have an int I is equal to, let's say I have an int number, right? Or let's use the camel case just to be a bit more fancy in this case, right? Let's say I say I want to pick a normal number and see what the Boolean would actually print out if I do a test. Let's try int, what should I be doing here? Int number, or first number. If it's camel case, how do I do it? First number is equal to one. And let's do first number is equal to 1. Okay, now let's remove, let's try this a bit out. I'm just going to be a bit sneakier, okay? Let's try this out. I'm going to put this out quickly. And let's say I want to print out, I want to print out his first number, larger first number. You can see I'm getting order because my typing goes larger than 2. Let's see what happens. Let's just see what happens and why and if it would work. Let's put it directly into the printout thing. Okay, so that's clearly, I'm just going to quickly remove this because this shouldn't be there. Let's try it again. Okay, shouldn't be there. I think this is something you got to be checking as well when you're programming. Make sure that everything adds up. Check this. You can usually just click here, right? And this should be indented. So click here and see. This should also be highlighted just to show you what the bracket is at the top. Sometimes you remove a bracket like this, right? And be very careful how you annotate your brackets. For every open bracket, there's got to be a closed bracket as well, right? So we want to check, we see, is there a closed bracket? No, it shows you this. It tells you exactly what's expected. Expected closed bracket. So let's do that just that. Let's run it again, and then we'll check the next one. Let's run it again quickly. Okay, now we see something interesting. It says false, but we haven't actually typed anything into the Boolean. Now, this is exactly what we did before, right? I mean, we said in Boolean is equal to false and Boolean is equal to true, and we just printed it out. And it told us false and true is exactly what we assigned the Booleans to. But now it just prints false. Now, it's interesting to see that the print line evaluates a Boolean itself, right? We don't have to say Boolean. It does it as an expression here. It evaluates the expression as a Boolean. So we can test a Boolean inside, let's say, a printout layer. And we can test a Boolean expression inside an if statement as well, right? We will get to that as well. This is going to be pretty fun stuff. But also, let's try something out as well. Okay. Let me just do this. Let's call this bool first number. Boolean first number, like we did before. First number is equal to, but instead of saying, let's try just assigning 1 to the Boolean, because when we talked about the matrix, we talked about zeros and ones. So let's just assign a 1 to the Boolean and see if we can assign an int to a bool, and if this would work. Okay, now we don't want the expression, right? We just want to print it out and see if it will actually print out 1, what will happen. And it will be interesting what the result will be in this case. Now it tells us incompatible types, int found required Boolean. This is a nice thing about IntelliJ. You guys might be more fancy than I am, but you would find out that your IntelliJ actually tells you what is the error, right? This is a nice thing about our program, which is like, it tells you what the problem is. It tells you it found an int. So I assigned an incorrect variable to a Boolean. So some programming languages, you can actually do this. You can actually assign something to the bool. It will convert. Java is not like this, right? So I can't assign a 1 if I call it bool, right? If I say it's Boolean first, I have to kind of either do an expression in this case. So in this case, I can try and do this. Let's quickly do this. If I say Boolean first number, let's say it's 1 larger than 2. Let's try this one out. I'm just going to try something out. And then let's run it and see why. First number. Yes. So this is interesting because we can also do an expression as a sign. So this gets evaluated as true or false, right? If you do it in the system.out.println, this gets evaluated. This is also evaluating the expressions, right? So this is important to play around with Booleans, to play around with the stuff that we teach you so you can become more familiar. Play around with things in this case and see, does it evaluate, doesn't it evaluate? So in this case, you can see it does evaluate expression. Java is very robust with expressions in this case. It's nice that it's so malleable. Some languages aren't as nice and as good artist as Java is in this case, but you still got to be careful, right? It's not as possible, so you still got to be careful. But you see it's printing out false. Why? Because it's doing the evaluation, assigning from left to right, right? This is the way that programming Java reaches. It does the right, looks at the right expression and evaluates it and assign it to the left. So it will say, is one larger than two, true or false? It's false. And assign it to first number, which is a Boolean, and then it prints it out. That's just the way we read it. Let's quick go into the slides because I'm going to move too slowly on this one. Okay, let's go back to the slides. Okay, so we talked about Boolean. This is exactly what I showed just now, right? This is just an extra variable. I'm not going to go back now, right now, to type this directly, but this is what I just showed. I said, is senior, in this case, would be a Boolean, and it will result as true because age is larger than 65, right? And this is the larger operator, so we'll talk about operators as well. Very important things in statements. We're going to talk about before we jump into if statements and else. So we're definitely going to be talking about or operators. The next one shows a has new record, right? So that's a Boolean has new record, and it evaluates true int values. Now, please notice that as I did before, the ints will evaluate in a Boolean expression, right? So the ints will evaluate. You can use ints as an evaluation, right? But when we assigned ints, remember there was an error, right? So when we assign ints, it is a different thing than evaluation in this case, right? So just bear in mind, I'm going to quickly jump back just because I don't want to leave any stone unturned. Let me just quickly jump back to the program and show you what I mean by this one. So when we go back to the program, we had first number, let me just try something else. This is the this was the expression. Okay, so int record 615 int value. So this was my first int, this is my second int, and this is has new record, and this is evaluation, right? So what we want to print is has new record. And then it evaluates has new record as true or false, and then puts it into this box, this little box we talked about last time. And then it prints it out. Let's quickly print it and see what we get. It says true. Okay, so let's go back and just to regress, let's try and put an expression in this one, right? So if I were to say, instead of value is larger than record, let's say is 615 larger than record. Let's mix it up. Let's mix it up quickly. Let's see if we can mix up, ints and variables in this case. So this is an int, right? And this is the variable that holds the value. Let's see if we can do this. And let's see if it will still express itself. Yeah, that's fine.